सो बेसिकली इन दिस वीडियो कुनाल ऑलरेडी प्लेस्ड इन टेक्सास इंस्ट्रूमेंट, तो उसके रिलेटेड इसे कुछ क्यू एन ए करेंगे एंड काफ़ी अच्छे क्वेश्चन हैं, तो आपको कुछ ना कुछ तो नॉलेज मिल ही जाएगी इस पॉडकास्ट से, पॉडकास्ट इंटरव्यू कुछ भी बोलो, लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज दैट टेल अस अबाउट अ बिट अबाउट योर जर्नी एंड हाउ डिड यू डेवलप एन इंटरेस्ट इन एनालॉग इंजीनियरिंग।
I developed my interest in analog engineering through doing various projects. So I was mostly interested in the code already, but I was inclined more towards the analog engineering because I did many of my projects in that specific domain.
Mostly interested in some subject or concept which make you more interested in analog engineering only, like there is other domains, not digital.
So mostly the RC circuit parts, the when you go into the deep of those concepts, then they become very obvious and interesting. So that made me grow my interest in the analog part. And okay. Digital, it's mostly it was kind of more tough for me because I felt like I had to memorize lots of things in it, and then after a long time, if I don't memorize it, I tend to forget those things.
Okay, so how did you apply for Texas Instrument and what is is through campus placement or an online portal or something? What
Texas Instrument was through the campus placement, so it came for campus hiring and therefore applied for it.
How many rounds there and what's the process exactly?
Rounds are mostly like 3 and 4, but in our college they only took 2 rounds. One was the OA and the other was the one interview round.
And what they exactly ask in OA?
OA was a bit there were 2 parts. One was aptitude, other was analog part, and it did not come for digital. It usually comes for digital as well. So aptitude was kind of tougher than what they usually ask. If you research the previous papers, what the questions TI used to ask. So in our case, aptitude was a little bit tougher. And the analog part was kind of same. They usually focus on basic concepts of RC circuits and then resonance and stuff, and then MOSFETs and VJTs and all those things. Okay. All the usually the gate level things.
Okay, and like how many students are appear for this OA and how many selected for second round?
Around 30 were appeared for the OA and 7 got selected for interview.
For second round,
interview
and,
round.
What were the questions in second round? Like how many questions and the interview is like how long is this? 1 hour or 2 hours?
Interview was like they gave us a timing. They gave us a 1 hour gap. Like this is the interview timing, 1 hour. But most of the time it exceeds 1 hour and usually goes around 1 hour 20 minutes or 1 hour 30 minutes something. Mm-hmm. And what did they ask? Questions are kind of basic questions like RC circuit question. They'll mostly be on the RC filter, first or the RC filter, and then they ask about MOSFETs and stuff. And then they ask about a very conceptual thing, like they gave me a black box and told me that if I give you the frequency response of this black box, then will you be able to identify the circuit inside the black box, such kind of like. And then they asked me an experimental question that told me to do an experiment to find out the VI characteristics of the circuit that they gave me.
Just okay, and around 1 hour interview. They took any HR round or HR question?
They take, but they did not took it in our college. But they usually take in other colleges.
Okay, like usually when you are preparing for Texas, how many rounds you expect?
We expected 2 rounds. One was interview round, technical round, and the other was HR round.
What resources or books would you recommend it for mastering analog concepts?
Analog, I would say maybe start with Behzad Razavi. But then after when you understand the concepts very well, then Behzad Razavi it bores. It's a little boring to watch lectures. So you can maybe go through his books. His books are fine. And other than that, there is one person. His name is Himanshu Agarwal. He is placed at Texas Instrument, and then after he got placed, he made a series on how he got placed. So you can follow his series, and he has made like a complete course on the analog domain and all the topic wise course. They are maybe available on free. There's also a roadmap of analog domain which you could follow. I followed the exact roadmap, and other than that, Chambian T is also good. Chambian T is actually better than all these things. You can follow Chambian T.
Next question is, which subject are most important for this role? How did you prepare for them?
Most important are the circuit parts, mainly the RC circuits and RL circuits. These two are the most important in the circuit. Other than that, they do not go to the RLC or the resonant part. They don't go, and then they like MOSFET, they like amplifier, so all those things. They'll ask if you are comfortable MOSFET or BJT, but they usually prefer that you should be comfortable in MOSFET.
Okay, did you practice any specific tool like MATLAB and Qt, LTSpice, or?
You have a project in any of those and it's in your resume, then you have to be thorough with it. So if they suppose go through your resume and then they find out that you are not comfortable with any of the software that you have used, then you'll be in trouble.
Okay, how did you balance technical preparation with software skills and resume building?
I completely ignored the software skills, to be fair. I completely focused on the hardware thing, and resume building comes from the very start. It doesn't clash with the interview preparation.
Okay, what kind of questions were asked in your technical round? Could you share an example of a challenging question, how you approached it?
So they gave me a RC filter, a normal RC filter, and they asked me the output waveform on the Vout. They told me Vout, and they asked me output waveform, and the input wave was a square pulse with frequency very much greater than RC. So this is like a very exact question that you'll get in books and other like sources. I told you Himanshu Agarwal, he had discussed exact question. So they asked me the exact question. I already knew what the question would be and already knew what the answer was. So there are basically three cases in which you have to solve, where RC is very much greater, where time period is very much greater than RC, time period is very much less than RC, and time period is comparable to RC. So he asked me all the three parts, and I knew all of them.
Any other question which are new for you?
Any other question is, they told me to find out the R out of amplifier.
Okay.
And then they gave me a very basic common drain amplifier, and they told me to find the R out from the drain terminal. And then when I told them the R out, they made the question more complicated by adding a resistance towards the gate. And because the gate does not take any current, so that resistance is kind of not needed, so it's like useless. So but they wanted to trap me over there. But if you know the concept, then you know that resistance is useless. So then they added more things towards the resistance, then they added a capacitor and all those things and made the circuit kind of complicated. So then they even asked me to draw the frequency response of the entire MOSFET.
Okay, so now some question for advice for aspirants. What are the top three things every aspirant should focus on for this role or for this company?
First thing is, there are times when aptitude questions can go tough. So I'll say you should also focus on aptitude, because many a times you ignore them because the concepts are very simple and you don't it's like the concepts are obvious and you don't forget them, but there are many times there is an easier approach to solve the questions which you wouldn't know, but if you know them beforehand, then it's better. Then other than that, HR round, you should also prepare for HR round. And if you are preparing for it and you missed few topics, and very much less time is very limited to you, then you should skip those topics and better focus on revising all the things you have covered till yet.
Okay, and if you could go back and change one thing in your preparation, what would it?
Nothing, one thing in my preparation.
Everything is on point.
It worked out for me, so everything was on point.
Like in interview time or somewhere you think one thing I can change?
Okay, in the interview. In the interview, or in the preparation. The thing I would change was maybe if I started a little bit early, then I could have covered the MOSFET series as well, which I did not. And when they gave me a MOSFET question to find the frequency analysis, it was completely new for me, and I had to work all the things at that point of the interview. So if I knew it before, it could have been better.
Okay, any last motivation tip for those who are watching and want to join in Texas?
Thing is, you should focus on basics. Very much focus on basics. They'll always try to trap you in the basic part. They'll never go very much deep. And if you know the basics, you can very much find the idea of how to, enter the deep concept. So even if they ask you a question which require a deep concept and you give them an approach, they'll be more than happy with you. So you should mostly focus on the basic concepts and make them as strong as possible.
Okay, Kunal, so thank you very much for giving this such inspiration answers. Thank you very much. Chalo guys, bye bye.